Hey Leute, willkommen zurück zu Let's Play The Great Ace Attorney Chronicles. Im letzten Part haben wir von Iris Wilson freundlicherweise eine Nachricht erhalten, die wir jetzt Gregson präsentieren können, mit der wir dann hoffentlich erreichen, dass er uns alles über den Fall sagt, was er so weiß. Sogar mit einer kleinen Münze noch drauf, ein bisschen Bestechung auch noch oder wie. Aber auch eine liebe und nette Nachricht. Naja, die ist auch nur so halb lieb eigentlich. Aber ja, wir zeigen die ihm auf jeden Fall mal. So. Inspector Gregson, do you have a moment?
I'm sorry to say I don't. I'm a very busy man. Much too busy to talk to a pair of four in gadabouts, that's for sure.
We have these for you. A present from Miss Iris Wilson.
What? For me? From her ladyship?
Her ladyship?
Give that here, at once. Come on, hand it over, that's for me.
Don't wait for me to give it to you, will you?
What was that coin exactly?
It's a silver crown, obviously, but it's a lot more than that. It's, well, it's an appearance fee, that's what it is.
An appearance fee? Oh, I see, you mean...
That's right, for the adventures of Herlock Sholmes. Ah, her ladyship always offers me a little financial reward for featuring me, every time.
Okay, deswegen.
Yes, yes, of course. I know all about your exploits, Inspector. I read them avidly.
Of course. Her using my name without my say-so does make me the butt of a lot of unpleasant jokes, but still.
I'm sorry, Inspector. That must be difficult for you.
Never you mind that. So, what do you want to know then, eh?
Sorry?
Tell the gentleman in black whatever he wants to know. I trust it won't be a problem, it says.
Well, obviously it's not a problem. Go on, fire away. What do you want to know?
Well, if you wouldn't mind, Inspector. We'd very much like to know the address of Mr. Natsume's lodgings.
Ah, the little knife-wielding mustache Japanese fellow. He lives in a right old hovel. It's just over there, look.
Ach, direkt da.
Ja, das war ja einfach.
On the first floor of that house on the corner where that rack of a bicycle is propped up.
That is nearby indeed.
If I remember rightly, the landlord is a Mr. John Garadab.
Das könnte ein Wortwitz sein.
Mr. John Garadab.
Garadab. Sprichst du auch richtig aus? Ich denke schon.
Garadab.
Garadab? 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 Garadab?
Ach, keine Ahnung. Right, well, if you see her again, you make sure you give her ladyship my regards, you hear? I mean it, you tell her that Gregson sends his very best wishes!
Don't worry, Inspector, we will.
Goodbye for now, then. And long live her ladyship!
Well, at least he told us what we wanted to know before he left.
Yes. So then, shall we go and see what we can find in Mr. Natsume's lodgings?
Definitely!
Aber über den Fall weiß ich immer noch gar nichts. So ungefähr, ich weiß halt, dass eine Frau von hinten erstochen wurde und das ist aber schon alles. Da wird doch wohl noch mehr los sein, oder? Hm. Naja, aber wir moven dann gleich mal. Genau, neue Location. Mhm. Zu Mr. Natsume's lodgings. The lodgings of Mr. Soseki Natsume, according to information gleaned from Inspector Gregson. Mhm. Ich bin mir gar nicht ganz sicher übrigens, was Lodgings exakt heißt. Auch einfach halt Wohnung halt oder so. Will ich es mal nachschauen? Ja, komm, Moment. Ja, Wohnung oder Unterkunft ist richtig. Also, die Wohnung von Mr. Soseki Natsume, zumindest bezüglich der Informationen, die wir von Inspector Gregson bekommen haben. Genau, und Susato sagt eben, dass wir hier noch nicht waren und dass sie sich fragt, was uns da wohl erwarten wird. Das frage ich mich auch. Mal schauen. Hoffentlich jetzt mal ein paar Infos. Wie wär's damit? Okay, ja, natürlich. Erstmal eine Kanone rumstehen. Let's go. Mr. Natsume's Lodgings.
May I help you?
Yes. Would this be the residence of Mr. John Garadab?
Indeed it would, sir. And who may I say is calling?
My name is Ryonosuke Naruhodo.
Mr. Naruhodo is representing Mr. Soseki Natsume. I believe he takes lodgings here. We would very much like to ask him some questions about our client.
One moment, please. I shall convey the message to Mr. Gary Depp.
Did you see that, Mr. Sato? That was a real-life English maid! I know. As I understand it, anyone of standing in English society employs a number of household staff. But that was the first time I've ever seen one in the flesh. Oh, the steak keeps getting better!
It certainly feels like we've really arrived now, doesn't it?
We need only to meet a butler and the experience will be complete.
Well, I'm not sure if I'd go that far, but I understand the sentiment.
Es ist lustig, wie sich ihre Backen zuerst ein bisschen nach unten bewegen oder ein bisschen hinterherhängen.
Thank you for waiting. Mr. Gary Depp will see you now. This way.
Oh, da ist er. Okay. Aber erstmal, okay, das Bild da hinten ist auch schon von ihm. Erstmal umgucken. Oh, das sieht lecker aus. Ja, erstmal Aussicht genießen.
This window looks out over Briar Road, where the young woman was attacked.
Oh yes, I can make out the policeman on the far side of the road investigating the crime scene.
The glass is rather murky, isn't it? You can't see very clearly.
Does the thing open at all, I wonder?
I shouldn't underestimate the bitterness of a London winter, sir.
Sorry?
As soon as you open that window, the tea will freeze in the pot. No Londoner would go opening windows at dusk in the middle of winter, I assure you.
It seems very unlikely that these two would have seen anything of the incident then.
So, bisschen essen.
Oh, look! What a wonderful collection of cakes lined up on that gleaming silver cake stand!
Lined up? It looks more like someone has half demolished them to me.
Afternoon tea is a time for of indulgence, you know. It is quite the English way. It is Mr. Gary Depp's custom to take two cakes with his tea.
That sounds delightful.
Oh, wait a minute though. There are at least 10 cakes on this cake stand.
Well, naturally, and it would never do to waste the leftovers. So whatever Mr. Gary Depp doesn't eat, I say to myself, John, you shall have to tidy up.
How magnanimous of you.
Dann noch hier. Dieses Sub, weil das auch einiges zerbrochen auch, sehe ich jetzt erst. Sogar ziemlich vieles da zerbrochen.
Look at this crockery on display here. It's rather unusual, isn't it?
Oh my, a genuine London dresser. Isn't it delightful? I thought the shelves seemed to be broken and the crockery is... Oh dear, it's in pieces.
It really is. The word cracked wouldn't do the chinaware justice.
Chinaware wahrscheinlich.
Ah, I wonder.
Das war sogar eine neue Pose, die sie hatte, glaube ich.
Perhaps the cannon was fired at...
Ich glaube, da wäre noch mehr kaputt. Yes, probably something like that. But let's not delve too deeply here. Oder ist sogar, wurde sogar doch die Kanone? Nee. Da wäre die ganze Wand durchbrochen wahrscheinlich. okay, Kerzenständer selber kann ich mir auch noch anschauen. Ja, das stimmt, weil die rechte, da ist nämlich keine Kerze drauf. Oder die ist schon komplett abgebrannt.
This old candle holder looks a little out of place here, wouldn't you say?
Yes, you're right. It's clearly supposed to be gold, but it's almost completely black for some reason.
Okay, sagt er zum ersten Mal was.
Ah, that old thing, yes. Just a cheap piece of ironmongery. Gimcrack, really.
Oh.
Used it when I was studying, don't you know? For my commission. I know it's old. Hardly worth hanging on to, really. But, well, still has its uses sometimes.
Of course.
Does everything in this room have some elaborate story behind it?
They're memories, Mr. Naruhodo. Memories.
Okay. Was ist das hier? Ist das eine Dusche? Oder Umkleide oder so?
Look at that enormous screen. It must have been put there deliberately, surely.
Yes, it certainly seems like someone's trying to hide something from you.
Ja, Dusche würde nicht viel Sinn ergeben hier. Umkleide aber auch nicht wirklich. Ja, mich würde auch interessieren, was da dahinter ist. What could be behind it, I wonder? Mal kurz nachschauen.
I'm going to have a very quick look. Just a little peek.
Ahem, ahem.
Maybe let's not, Mr. Sato.
Oh.
I think the maid is going to head us off with a cup of tea.
Ahem, ahem.
Okay. Was liegt da am Boden? Kann ich nicht wirklich erkennen, leider. Aber ich kann es mir auch nicht anschauen. Dann wird schon nichts Wichtiges sein.
Okay, hier, Bild. That portrayal of Mr. Garrett Ebb is glaring at me, I swear.
Have you noticed that all the little frames contain photographic prints of Mr. Garrett Ebb as well?
Yes, and there seems to be a statue of a lion on the mantelpiece as well.
Ah, yes. Seemed to come back from the local pawnbroker with that little trinket.
Seemed to come back? What do you mean?
The chap who runs the place is a belly wizard. Went in to sell him something and came out with that thing. In point of fact, now I think about it, I rather often find myself leaving the place with something I don't need.
The lion ornament certainly does seem surplus to requirements.
So Sato-san doesn't pull her punches, or her throws for that matter. Okay, Medaille. Mit einer Krone drauf sogar.
That looks like a Medal of Honor, and it's showcased on a very grand banner.
Yes, it's displayed with some pride, I would say, although it bothers me that it's not straight. Das stimmt.
What, that old thing?
Sorry?
I should be glad to see the back of it, but the general would turn in his grave if I disposed of it. The wall is the best place for it. Keeps the body thing out of my way.
So it's just been polished to shine by accident, I suppose.
There appears to be an inscription on the medal itself, look! Let me see, it says, for distinguished participation.
Sounds like the kind of honors even I could be in line for. Nur eine Teilnahmeurkunde quasi.
Well, one doesn't like to blow one's own trumpet, but I was given that for my time in the army. Can't measure an officer by the number of medals to his name, of course. Common knowledge in military circles.
Okay. Da, ich werde mal die beiden erst am Ende anklicken, glaube ich. Uniform. That uniform looks fairly ancient, doesn't it?
It's clearly been well looked after, though.
That old thing. Huh. Not much better than rags, really.
Oh?
Wore that ceremonial garb at my retirement bash, you know? But I'm not one for dwelling on the past, me. Would have gladly thrown it out, but you know how it is. Anyway, doesn't hurt to have the odd piece of memorabilia lying around, does it?
Oh, I see. Perhaps we should leave the past in the past.
Okay. So, ich glaube, auf der Seite, abgesehen von den beiden, natürlich habe ich alles. Ja, ich glaube schon. Okay, dann mal auf die linke Seite und nehmen wir das andere Offensichtliche. That's a full-size cannon! What's it doing in here?
Oh my, it's real. I thought it might be a replica.
That old thing? Bah, that's little more than a toy.
Sorry?
The army was selling it off when I retired, so I decided to give it a new home. Never know when the enemy might attack next. Jolly useful to have a cannon about the house.
Really? It isn't overkill?
Be prepared, I always say. You never know what this twisted world is going to throw at you next, boy.
Do you think there may be trouble brewing, Mr. Gary Depp?
Always is. Take Chowen here. Never fails to have a clean apron in reserve. Dries them over the barrel, you see. Ja, das sehe ich. They dry very well on the cannon there, Chowen tells me. Which rather proves my point, I feel.
It's been reduced to a drying rack. No wonder the huge cannon looks like it's hanging its head in shame.
okay.
Die Bücher, wo ich im Weg bin, ja. I notice you have a pile of books here, Mr. Gary Depp. Do you enjoy reading?
Ever experience a London winter, boy? The nights are long. No better way to pass the time than in front of the fire with a jolly good book.
Oh, there's a copy of Rancid Magazine here, I see. No doubt Mr. Gary Depp enjoys the adventures of Sherlock Holmes too.
Das ist auch das Einzige, worüber du nachdenken kannst, oder?
The great detective has a great many followers, it would seem.
Okay. So, aber dann habe ich jetzt, glaube ich, wirklich den ganzen Rest. Nein, hier noch nicht. Ah, Ados Mortar Shells, der Enormous.
Ah, I hadn't noticed. What are they doing here?
Habe ich auch zuerst gar nicht bemerkt. Ah, those old things. Diese alten Sachen immer.
Couple of little rounds I accidentally fired into the barracks during training, you know. Became a bit of colorful legend and folklore, that incident.
You mean you deliberately hunted out the spent shells? Well, I wouldn't say deliberately, exactly. They're only scrap iron after all, usually just thrown away, I believe. But you never know when things might come in useful, do you? Useful for what exactly? Yes, well... Joe in here did manage to knock one of the body things on my foot the other day while she was dusting.
Oh no!
Hadn't shed a tear since 1869 before then, you know. Maybe we consider throwing them away? Okay. So, aber jetzt kann ich noch mit den beiden auch quatschen. So. Good day to you. Wir haben doch schon gesprochen. John Garrett, at your service.
Pleased to meet you, sir. This is Ryunosuke Naruhodo. He's a defense lawyer.
Do excuse me not getting up. Took a shot to the knee a few years back in the Battle of Maiwa, don't you know? Earned a medal for my pains, but had to withdraw from service. Handed over the reins to the up-and-comings. So he's a retired soldier. It's a hell of a job getting up and downstairs now, I can tell you. Don't get out much, as you can imagine. Yes, it's quite a climb up there, up here to the second floor, isn't it? I was panting at the top of the stairs.
You really must take more exercise, Mr. Naruhodo.
Do you think so?
Well, Mr. Gabby Depp, no doubt you were very courageous to earn yourself a medal.
Oh, it was nothing. The medal is just a folder roll, really. Wouldn't like to offend the general, though. So I grudgingly displayed it on the wall. Das wissen wir schon, ja? Why don't you fetch it down, Joanne? Let these good people see it properly. Joanne, fetch the... Dash it, all woman, be careful!
Oh, dearie me, I do beg your pardon, sir.
You jolly nearly took the skin off my hands.
I shall be more careful, sir.
So anyway, there you have it. Living the quiet life now. Yes, I see. Now then, I hear you want to know about the chap lodging downstairs, is that right?
Yes, we would be very grateful if you could answer some questions for us.
Only too pleased, naturally. Especially if it helps to keep the peace here and lightly. We forged an alliance with the Empire of Japan recently, as I'm sure you are aware. So this case is very much in the public eye, as it were. Oh, is it? Even had some famous detective poking around, you know. In this old house, would you believe?
Yes, Mr. Herlock Sholmes!
Could have been. Didn't catch the chap's name. Not really my cup of tea or the detective business. Okay, sind's doch nicht seine Bücher.
Oh, but you have a copy of Rand's magazine here, so...
Eh? No.
Anyway, the chap's investigating the foreigner's room as we speak.
So he's in Soseki-san's room. Ah. It's a bally nuisance, is what it is. The whole neighborhood's twitching its curtains now. I don't like all this fuss. It's surely unsettling. Okay, jetzt können wir dann reden. Mhm. Über Mr. Natsume und auch über den Vorfall vor 2 Tagen. Okay, aber ich würde erstmal sagen, dass das hier war für... Das ist ja komisch. Die erscheinen jetzt gar nicht hier. Ich muss nochmal... sie anklicken. Egal. Das hier war für diesen Part von Let's Play The Great Ace Attorney Chronicles. Beim nächsten Mal reden wir dann mit den beiden ein bisschen und ich hoffe aber, dass wir dann vielleicht auch zu Holmes gehen können. Sholmes meine ich. Mann ey, ich komme da so durcheinander. Dass wir zu Sholmes gehen können und ihn auch wieder treffen, hätte ich Lust. Jetzt haben wir ihn ja schon länger nicht mehr gesehen und ich habe wieder Bock irgendwie auf ihn und auf seine falschen Deduktionen, die wir dann richtig machen müssen. Bin auf jeden Fall schon gespannt. Gut. Also dann, Leute, bis zum nächsten Mal. Ciao.